Okay, so already we have seen the conventional method of converting a decimal number to other base system. We've already seen how to convert a decimal to binary. We saw some examples also. But the problem with the conventional method is that it may be too big in some of the examples, right? Suppose you get a number 31. 31 is a decimal number and you have to convert it into binary. So this will be too long. You have to divide 31 repeatedly with 2. This may take a lot of time. Suppose you have a number x of base 10 and you have to convert it into 2. How many steps is it going to take? It is going to take log x base 2 steps. This will take this many steps to convert it into binary number. How do we get this? Suppose x is a power of 2, 2 power n. You have to divide it repeatedly with 2. First you divide it with 2, you get 2 power n minus 1. Then you get 2 power n minus 2. You divide it until you get 1. Fine. How many steps will this procedure take? You have to divide this n times with 2. Then only you are going to get 1. 1 is 2 power n minus 1, right? So this will take n steps. What can you write n as? See, log x. X is 2 power n. You take its log with respect to 2. Log 2 power n with respect to 2 is going to be n. This is what we have said. It's going to take log x base 2 steps. Okay, n steps it's going to take. So what shortcut we can use here is, we all know that in a binary number, the numbers are placed like this. Moving from the LSB, this is 2 power 0. Then the next number is going to be 2 power 1. Then 2 power 2. 2 power 3. And so on. This is how you represent a binary number. We all know this. Right? This is 1. This, the significance of this bit is 1. The value, the weight of this bit is 1. The weight of this bit is 2. 4. And so on. So what do we do is, for a given number, suppose you are given 31, so you take the highest power of 2 which is less than this number. See, what is the highest power of 2 which is less than this number? It's going to be 2 ki power 4. 16. 16 is the highest power of 2 which is less than 31. Fine. So you, what do we do? This is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. Let us first write the weights of these bits against them. Weight of this bit is 1, then 2, 4, 8 and 16. So what is the highest power of 2 less than 31? It's 16. So I write a 1 against it. Then you subtract 16 from 31. We are going to get 15. What is the highest power of 2 less than 15? It is 8. So you write 1 against 8. Then you subtract 8 from 15. You get 7. What is the highest power then? 4. So you write 1 against it. Then you get 3. Highest power is 2. You write 1 here. And you get 1. So we get 1 here also. So this is going to be the binary representation for 31. Try one thing yourself. Try to represent 67. 67 is a decimal number. Try to represent it in binary using this shortcut. See what is going to be the highest power of 2 less than 67, it is going to be 64. Then you get 3. Then the highest power is 2. Then you get 1. Okay, so the binary representation is going to be 1 for 64, 0 for 32, 0 for 16, 0 for 8, 0 for 4, 1 for 2 and 1 for 1. See, what is the weight of this bit? It's 64. This is 2 and this is 1. So you see 64 plus 2 plus 1 is going to be 67. Now let us quickly look at another conversions. We are going to convert decimal number into octal. Decimal to octal conversion. We already know the procedure, so we are directly taking an example. Suppose you have to convert 41.6875. This is a decimal number. And you have to convert it into a octal number system. What is the highest possible digit in an octal number system? It's going to be 7. We've already learned about this, fine. So now let us look at this example. How are we going to convert the integer part? We are going to repeatedly divide this with 8. we divide it by repeatedly with the base of the required number system. Here the required base is 8, so we divide this repeatedly with 8. Divide 41. What is going to be the question? We get 5. And what is going to be the remainder? It's going to be 1. Fine. So what is going to be the number? See, now further 5 is not divisible with 8. Fine, you get the quotient as 0 and the remainder as 5. So here we have got the quotient as 0, so we stop and then you move this way. So the required octal number would be 51. This is the integral part of the required octal number. What do we do for the fractional part? You multiply it repeatedly with 8, right? You multiply this with 8. You get 5.5. You can check it later. Okay, so the required integral part is 5. 5 is okay. Then you multiply 0.5. 0.5 comes here. And you multiply it again with 8. What do you get? You get 4. This is a complete integer. Okay, complete integer. So you consider it as it is. And then we move this way. So what is the final representation for this number? 41.6875. Can be represented as 51.54 in octal number system. Now let us quickly look at one example of conversion of decimal number to hexadecimal. So we are given a number 227. This is a decimal number and we have to convert it into hexadecimal. Hexadecimal has base 16. We've already learned this, right? Base of an hexadecimal number is going to be 16. And how are we going to convert it? You know this. We divide this number repeatedly with 16. So when you divide this with 16, you get 14 as the quotient and you get 3 as remainder. Okay. Try to divide it again. 14 is not divisible with 16. So you get quotient as 0 and remainder as 14. So when you get quotient as 0, you stop. Now you have to move like this. Okay, but you should remember, what is the representation of 14 in hexadecimal number system? It is E. We have learned this already. 14 is represented as E in hexadecimal number system. So what is going to be the answer here? We are going to get E3.